Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about lactosuperin or lacoperin. The bacterium E. coli possesses a highly effective lactose metabolism process. The lacoperin is a single expressible unit of DNA that encodes three proteins crucial in lactose metabolism. If lactose is not present in the growth media, the bacterium does not waste energy by expressing these proteins. These proteins are only produced when lactose is present to be metabolized. We will learn how lactose activates the expression of these lactose metabolizing genes through this animation. In the absence or presence of lactose, the lac repressor protein encoded by the LacI gene is produced. The lac repressor attaches to the lac operator site in the absence of lactose. Like a DNA roadblock, repressor binding to the operator stops the RNA polymerase from progressing. Lac structural genes are unable to be transcribed by RNA polymerase, hence no proteins are produced. Lactose binds to the lac repressor's allosteric site when it is present in the cell medium. The repressor's conformation is altered as a result of this. The repressor can no longer attach to the lac operator site in this configuration. RNA polymerase is able to transcribe the structural genes without the repressor inhibiting it. The lac structural genes are thus expressed in the presence of lactose. Lactose metabolism needs the proteins encoded by the Z and Y genes. The lacoperin is an inducible system, which means it is switched off until an inducer lactose is introduced. Other operins, such as the TRP operin, works in the reverse way. This system produces gene in the operin until a repressor is activated, which then shuts down the expression.